I found out something. Some of you here right now, I'm talking by the Spirit. By now, even before now, you are the one who should have walked the street raising cripples, raising the dead, doing all kinds of incredible wonders in the name of Jesus. But let me tell you why you have been limited. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Some of you by now should have been able to build greatest businesses in this city. By now, some of you should have been able to be doing great exploits in this city. But you are still held bound, letting your pastor be the only one who is shaking the town. You are not shaking. Why? Because you are not paying the price your pastor pays. You're not paying the price he pays. You're not going through the same furnace he goes through. In your chosen field, you're supposed to be the principality there. But you've allowed principalities and powers, wickedness in high places, to lay siege over your life. Day in, day out, the same story. Day in, day out, the same story. Let me tell you, do you think your mind can fathom a billion naira project except it be by the Spirit? Except it be by the Spirit. Except it be by the Spirit. That's why I am now. Billion naira projects. That's why I am now. By the Spirit. One of these Wednesdays or Sundays, you will come here, you will see us here again. And you will even hear any announcements. You just come here, you wonder, where is church? Where is pastor? They say they have packed out. You'll be wondering how. I cook things in the Spirit. If you go to Dunamis, for instance, and see what that young man did the day I went there and saw that church, I looked at the man, I'm fatter than he is. One slim man, you'll be wondering, is it this man who is packing this place out and in like this? Is this man who built this structure? I had one pillar in the church with one trailer of cement. To build one pillar outside there was one trailer of cement. And then I looked at the structure. It is not your physique that does signs and wonders. It is the human spirit inside. God said, let them have dominion. Not your body. If your spirit is not cooked on the inside, no dominion outside. Because your body is not designed for dominion. Your body is the house of the Spirit. It is your spirit that is designed for dominion. I want to help you drop weights now. I see some of you, your weight is like paper. It's paper light. Paper light, faith is dead. Everything is dead. You can't believe God for anything tangible. I don't go pricing for a billion naira project with money in my account. No, I have enough faith in my account. Because I'm alive in the Spirit. I'm dead to the flesh. I'm alive in the Spirit and dead to the flesh. I'm alive in the Spirit and dead to the flesh. That's why I'm able to dare some things that you cannot fathom in your mind. Stop making the word of God of no effect in your life by your tradition. Can I come to Hebrews chapter 12? Show them Matthew chapter 15. Let me show you the response of Jesus to the Sadducees and Pharisees. Some of you are Sadducees and Pharisees in church. Why are you a Pharisee? You are too far to see. You are in the church, but too far to see. Why are you a Sadducee? You are too sad to see. That's why you come to church gloomy, when the Bible says that the joy of the Lord is your strength. But because you are carrying flesh all around you, in the flesh there's weakness.